I noticed immediately once I started dealing with the CBD oils, I started sleeping better. My friend Cedar, he was telling me, like, look, you know, take it at night after you eat first, take a little toothpick, put it under your tongue, and you're going to notice you're going to start resting better as it starts getting into your system. So I noticed immediately I started feeling better. I had a better performance. So I had some CBD oil spray that you could use as just a throat spray. I just started relying on these products, you know. They had my appetite right, you know what I'm saying? And if I didn't have an appetite, I would smoke a little bit and get my appetite up. So overall, compared to the Oxycontins and the Ambient and stuff, I just say, you know, this was a Fabergé egg. And you hear all type of stuff about holistic treatment versus the medical marijuana stuff. And, you know, us as a people, we got to do better, because what I come to realize is the same stuff that they make out of these pills are out of plants. And they just cut it with all these toxins and stuff, you know. So God didn't make the pill, he made the plant. And you have a stigma because you're thinking, like, okay, oh, this brother with dreadlocks, or this sister with a dashiki, or some herbalist. You think, like, oh, this is some witch doctor shit or something. This is the real. And had I not gone through this experience, I don't know if I would have taken heed to it as much. So I just really recommend that people, I mean, see how it works for you. But for me, it was a miracle turnaround. I'm still here. People say I look better after the surgery than I looked before the surgery. I find it hard to believe, you know what I'm saying, since I, you know. but yeah, man, I swear up and down by the CBD oils. And, you know, I want to make it my mission to be able to help people through this experience, because it's a monster. It seems scary, man, but if you just deal with it head on, it's not as bad as you think, opposed to if I would have waited. Now, if I would have waited, I would have probably been in front of you with a wheelchair. Who knows? I might have not been here today, you know? And through it all, man, you know, it's just really about keeping a healthy mind and a healthy body. And, you know, there's a lot of fear, a lot of propaganda, but I just say go through it. And you got a friend in herbs. You got a friend in the CBD oils. You got a friend in me. Help to get the medicine. Because honestly, if you think about it, I was sort of breaking the law trying to get the medicine or to take the medicine, you know? And right now, we just need to decriminalize it. Stop the crap. Get on with the care, you know? So, you know, get more people aware. So stop the crap. Start with the care. Make people more aware. You know, this is not the 50s. All this fear and propaganda needs to go. And I think that also in our communities, if we do focus on this, we can use a lot more money for the schools. Like I said, I think that it's not a gateway drug, whether CBD or marijuana. It's a medicine. You know, if it's anything, a gateway, if it's a gateway to anything, it's to prison. And I'm tired of seeing our brothers going to prison for something that we should... Actually, they're making money off of us through prisons when we should be able to make the same type of money and put it towards our communities, towards our schools, towards healthcare. You know? So this is what it's about. F up cancer. We're going to fuck it up. You know what I'm saying? Or we're going to say, fuck it. So, you know, if you want to get involved, man, just go to fupcancer.com. It's going down real big July 9th. Like I said, the whole hip-hop community coming in to make this thing just a big, big platform, you know? I don't know anybody nowadays that has not been touched by cancer. It just seems like they're passing it out like fast food, and it might be the food, it may be the water, but whatever it is, they're passing it around like a cold, you know. And I'm just fortunate. A lot of the joke that people say about me is I treat cancer like a cold, because they didn't see the effects on how it tore my body down. But I just kind of keep the faith. I knew God was with me from that minute. From the minute I was told, but definitely that whole hospital experience. So, you know, this hip-hop community, shouts out to Pee Wee Longway, shouts out to K-Camp, shouts out to Cody Shane, shouts out to Trillville, shouts out to everybody, Headcrack, everybody that signed on so far to perform for these performances, OGPI, Tina P,